goes out to my mom.
I'm so used to being bold, but not no more. I'm buying all the things I never could afford.
Teddy Swims is the guy with the big beard and the even bigger voice.
Let it burn.
Atlanta native, Swims has been making music for years, but it was his recent cover of MJ, Journey and Shania Twain that sent his streaming numbers into the stratosphere.
You're still the one that I love, the only one I dream of, still the one I kiss, good night.
With new music on the way and a cracking collab with Meghan Trainor, everything is going swimmingly for Teddy. He's here now to tell us all about it.
Please don't make promises that you can't keep. Your best intentions end up hurting me.
Good look right here, it's Teddy Swims! You forget, I see you've made yourself at home with the newsreader's folder already.
What have you got behind that folder there?
You know, just a little work. I'm a businessman. Yeah, nothing crazy going on over here.
What is your business?
It's called Businessmen and Associates and Co. And we handle business for other business and entrepreneurs and such.
I love it when guests come and do their taxes on the show. This is very nice of you. So, Teddy Swims, can you? Swim.
Oh, okay. I thought I was going somewhere.
It was going nowhere.
Somebody didn't tell him to do his research because I am so insecure to say this, but no, I cannot.
Not very good. To learn. Australia loves to teach people to swim. You should learn to swim while you're out.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, so, no, that's not happening, is it?
Well, no, I can paddle. I'm not going to die. I'm not going to drown. But, you know, it's just not my strong suit. It's not my comfortable place.
It's also not your real name. So, how did you end up with Teddy Swim?
Teddy Swims, I've been called Teddy my whole life, but Swims was an acronym for someone who isn't me sometimes.
Someone who isn't me, Swims.
Yeah, yes. It's just kind of a, insecure, neurotic, don't know who I am, and I'm always constantly figuring it out, I guess.
Well, your first thing at school, you're from Atlanta, Georgia, where you played football. You played in the football team.
Yeah.
But you also did, like, musical theatre or theatre there. And often those worlds don't cross over in high school. So where did that make you land, in the cafeteria?
Well, I didn't get into theater until I was about 16 in high school. My best friend Jesse still plays with me, writes a lot of stuff with me, and he's been my best friend since I was in sixth grade. And I mean, it didn't really work out. I was playing football. I'm from a football team, American football at that, of course. Football wasn't going to work for me being 5'7", so let's be honest with ourselves. So,
unless you were going to be the football.
Yeah, unless I was the football. I'm sure shaped like one. So, but luckily I found that and had this absolute love for it. So,
we got a photo of you, and this really caught my attention. This is you as Han Solo.
Yeah, Star Wars fan.
So this is like a musical parody of Star Wars that you did. Please tell me everything about it.
Okay, so my senior year, honestly, I was not much of a student. My theater teacher, Pete Towton, salt of the earth, man, best guy in the world, really changed my life. My senior year, we were in a bunch of debt in high school and with our theater department, and he came up with this idea. We called it Swamp, Star Wars, a musical parody. We made it after Number 4, A New Hope, and so we wrote it based off of... We could basically take songs from, any other musical and kind of gear them off of parody lost. So we took, Millennium Falcon and made it like Grease Lightning, And so
funny.
I kind of casted myself as this Chris Farley version of Han Solo. I actually have right here on my calf here a tattoo of Chris Farley dressed as Han Solo, and we were able to take like One Day More from Les Mis and make it use the force, this whole thing, and we sold out 2 back-to-back weekends, kind of saved our theater department, and I think they just kind of gave me my diploma. You get out of here, bud. You did good.
Well, it sounds like you've always kind of followed your passion, and then in 2019, this amazing thing happened. I love these stories where you blew up on YouTube with the covers that you were doing of other famous people's songs, including we saw the beautiful Shania Twain. Oh, my God.
I know.
The Queen, man.
Please tell me that she has seen it.
Yeah, she has, man. She had, like, when I first kind of started, she had sent me, like, tweeted at me, like, great cover.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And, of course, I was freaking out about it.
I think she was going to say, I'm suing or something.
Yeah, I mean, glad she didn't. But she said great cover, so, I mean, that's about as much as I got of it. But, you know, like...
It could have been worse than that.
Yeah, great, that's the Queen, good,
yes,
man.
Yes, absolutely. Like, your first single broke. Were you broke when you wrote it?
When we started writing it, that was when I first, so right before the pandemic, I took all, me and my whole team, my best friends that I've come up with, did all these covers with, we all high school, middle school buddies and stuff, and right when we started this Teddy Swims thing, June 25th of 2019 was our first cover of Rock With You by Michael Jackson. It was 10 years after he died. We just kind of wanted to pay homage to him, and we all promised each other when that started working, that I was like, just give me 6 months, man. We all got into a house, moved in together. There were about 12 of us. We moved into a 5-bedroom house. And I mean, my production manager was building plyboard walls to split rooms in between, and we turned it to an 8-bedroom house and all moved in together. And was like, look, man, let's keep working these jobs. Let's keep doing this and give me 6 months. And sure enough, December 24th of 2019, they less than 6 months, I signed to Warner Records. And now me and all my best friends were on salary and we're doing great. And
so glad.
So broke came from that.
And also because you'd backed yourself in by getting all the
stickers on your head, hadn't you?
You weren't going to be getting a job on a bank board anytime.
Yeah, but he's got this ability.
He's got his business.
Well, I was already an entrepreneur. Anyway. or I was an alcoholic. I don't know, one of those.
Teddy, of course, has a tour in Australia. The bad news is it's already sold out. It's good for him. Bad for you if you've seen him and said, I want to see him. Thanks for dropping by when you absolutely didn't have anything to gain from it.
Yeah, no, I definitely... Well, see, the thing is, man, like I said, our first ever one we ever put out, the Michael Jackson cover, we woke up that next day and it was like at 150,000 views on it, right?
Amazing.
And it was because of... we woke up and we're like, how did all this happen? How did all these views come in? And it was because I guess when we were asleep, you guys were wide awake and all of our views came from here and New Zealand. And it's been like our biggest, I guess, fan base up until this last 3 years. So this has been this has been like a big, you know, big bucket list moment for me to finally come out.
Well, welcome to Australia. In 10 years' time, you will officially be Australian. That's the way it seems to work. The tour is sold out, as I mentioned. The new single with Meghan Trainor, Bad For Me, is out now, though. Would you please thank Teddy Swims?